Good evening and welcome to Sports Federation TV, the show where we talk about a whole range of different codes of sport brought to you by the Western Cape Provincial Sport Confederation. Tonight's show, we talk to a hurdle specialist who's made his impact internationally. We talk martial arts, we talk Q sport, and we talk something that's just happened yesterday. Safa and the tenants been locked out of Athlon Stadium. We'll get back to that story a bit later. Mr. Antonio Alkana, how you been?
Fine, thanks, yourself.
Good, good. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
You burst onto the scene in 2015, making your name. People didn't even know you existed. Tell us a bit about that. Just before 2015, what happened? How did you get into hurdles?
Okay, I started on school like every normal kid. Loves athletics, love running, want to be the fastest on the school. And after school, my mother told me I must join the athletics club in Belleville. So I'm currently at Belleville Athletics Club. I started there with Coach Marcel Otto. I've been training, working on my speed before we came to the technique. So I did a lot of 100s, 200s and hurdles at the same time, like at events. I'll do 3 events just for my build up, getting the speed, then focusing on technique till I decided to just do the hurdles.
So you were doing athletics at school prior to to embarking on yeah. hurdles. So were you never a hurdler? Were you always just a sprinter?
I was always a hurdler, but just I wasn't as fast as the other kids. I was always 5th, 6th in the shadow of the other guys shining. Yeah, I was always a hurdler, but I was just not as fast as the others.
And Marcel changed that for you, in your opinion, the technique.
He did a lot. I was fast. I think I had an average of 10.85 on school, my last day of school.
Nice.
That was just me pure.
Yeah.
Just the pure speed. Obviously, it wasn't good enough as the other guys were quicker than that. But yeah.
And then when you joined Belleville, what was it like coming into a club as opposed to just running from March or from Jan to March, basically?
It was something different. I came there with my all-star tackies. I didn't know what to expect.
Yeah.
Training was something different for me, something new, because I didn't train. Like on school, we just did our normal PT in the mornings for the athletic season that month, month and a half, and that was it. So going to the club was different, doing a winter program. It was like a whole year build up just to compete for a few months.
Yeah.
Like I didn't know that until I joined the club.
And in your opinion, was that the catalyst to get you onto the national ball, onto the national scene? Tell us a bit about participating in your first club event.
My first club event? Is it club event?
Local, yeah. Because obviously you participated at school.
Yeah, yeah.
Now you join Belleville and then you go and you participate in a meet, yeah.
That was something different. Like I didn't know, like I said, when I started joining the club, before that I just ran my race. There was nothing of warming up, nothing like that. It's just, you just go run and go. Obviously joining the club, you start, you're learning, you need to warm up, you need to stretch, you need to do all those drills before you start running.
Yeah.
So my first race, I don't know, I can't remember exactly, but I didn't do too bad though, because it was only 3 in the race. So I think I came 3rd or 2nd, I'm not sure. But it was a nice experience, like just to compete, doing a different race to just doing the school races.
And then the progression from there into breaking into the national circuit, how did that come about?
It was also with my coach himself, like I said, he wanted to get my speed up first before we started tackling the hurdles itself. So yeah, so we got my speed up, then we decided, okay, like 2015, we're now just focusing on the hurdles itself. And then from there, I got the breakthrough, went to my first world champs.
What was that like, competing here locally and then suddenly you on the world scene?
It was stressful going over to my first year going to Europe, just to go and run there, do a few races. I didn't expect to qualify for the world champs. And then I qualified at a meet in Finland, I remember. It was like ice cold, 10 degrees, something we're not used to as Capetonians.
For sure.
So yeah, then I qualified there, ran with Dylan Robles, the guy that used to hold the world record. So it was something nice, like seeing those guys, names that they used to Google. Like when I started training, I started Googling, okay, this is how you do things, this technique, or things like that. Just learning from the best.
Yep.
And now you're starting to compete with him. It was nerve-wracking, I won't lie. I remember my first race in Europe, I shivered in the blocks. You can't see it on the video
footage,
itself,
yeah.
but
yeah.
I know, like, yo, I was shivering. Like, just knowing, like, this name is in this race, and I'm competing with him.
So
it was actually an honor just to be there with him.
So there's a bit of nerves and a bit of cold in the same...
Yeah, it's like everything in one. Mixed emotions, everything.
And did you take selfies with these guys? Or because often you're starstruck, you see, yo, look who's here with me.
I didn't actually take any pictures. I'm a shy guy. I won't go up to you, ask you if I can take a picture with you or so. Like if I get it on maybe I Google our races or something and I can see we have pictures together. That's
yes.
But I won't go up to you and ask you for a picture.
On that note, if you walk in Tiger Valley Mall because you live in the northern suburbs, do people come up to you and say, hey, can we have a photo? Does that happen?
There's a few, but it will be school kids, like guys that look up to me, I think, that will recognize me. There will be a few, like I say, elderly people that follow athletics that will walk up to me and want an autograph or a photo.
And how does it make you feel?
It's nice. Like I said, I'm a shy person. I don't like that center of attraction. Like, everybody's looking. What's happening? Who's this guy? Why are they asking pictures?
Yeah.
Like, why are they want photos with him? Like, it's something nice, but at the same time, I'm like, yeah, okay. Sweating now.
In terms of preparation, I mean, you spoke about school, coming into a club. It was completely different. Mm-hmm. And you had to now train for an entire year. Mm-hmm. What changes in your life as an athlete and as a person to adapt to something like that, as opposed to just 3-4 months of running?
I think it's just you become more disciplined, because now you know that, okay, we're training 4:30, we need to be there 3:30 to start warming up. And at the time when I just started, I used to travel to the track. So I start traveling like, say, 2 hours, 2.5 hours before I start training. I start traveling to the track. So it's something different though.
And now you do this full time?
I'm doing this full time, enjoying it. I have a passion for the sport. I love what I'm doing. And hopefully I'll just go faster and faster.
So now that you're doing this full time, how do you fund this thing? Do you have sponsors? Who helps you pay for all the things that you do?
I've got the nutrition sponsor, PVM. I'm very thankful, grateful to them. They're helping my nutrition, this is my recovery, my protein, things like that after training. And then again, my club, the Athletics Club, Western Province, they fund my trip to Europe. So it's a lot out of my pocket that they're saving me on. The plane ticket's expensive.
For sure.
And my accommodation outside. So I'm very thankful to them.
And living costs, you still live with your father?
I'm married, living with my father. My mother passed away last year. So me and my wife were living with my father because he's alone there. We decided to live with him.
Yep.
So yeah.
I know that at one point last year you had a bit of a rough time. You picked up an injury, I think around about this time, Jan. What was that like?
That was tough. It was a tough time. Like, I didn't expect to be injured. Like, I was in a crazy shape. I was planning to do World Indoors that year, 2017. But then the injury came. Tore my hamstring in grade 2 there.
Yep.
And I had to start rehab, obviously, after that. A whole month of no training, just focusing on getting back on track.
Going from being in peak performance to being injured, to rehab. What is that transition like, and coming back from that? How does it affect you as an athlete?
It's difficult though, because the thing is, the injuries sometimes is a mind game. It's in your head. You, like, the physio will clear you, fully healed, you're good to go. But then again, you hold back in the mind. Like, you hold back when you're running. Like, you start limping. You don't even need to limp, but you're limping because you're so close. You don't want to get hurt again. So it is a tough path for an athlete to go through an injury.
How do you see changes in your body as a result of athletics, number one? And how does it affect your mental state in life in general?
I think I'm more healthier than I used to be. Like, as I'm growing in the sport as well. I'm old, but I'm still growing. I'm not really old, but I'm growing in the sport. Like, I'm young in the sport. I didn't start at a very young age though, like professionally. So, yeah.
Where do you, give me one or two of the highlights that of events and things that you've done over this last 4 years, 3 years.
I represented our country at the Rio Olympics.
What was that like?
That was awesome. It was great. I think it's every athlete or any athlete, doesn't matter what sporting code, just to represent your country or your family at the Olympic Games. That was one of the biggest highlights. And then again, breaking the African record 2017.
Young man, other than participating and actually running, what do you do with the rest of your day?
At the moment, I'm helping coaching at DF Milan. I've got a friend, Elro Dixon. He works at HPC at DF Milan High School. So I'm coaching the hurdles, long hurdles, short hurdles. There's a few talented athletes. Like, they have a future in athletics.
What is long hurdles and short hurdles? Everybody just know of hurdles. What's the difference?
400 hurdles, 110, 100.
Okay, so distance, not distance, in terms of height or length.
No.
Okay. And how often are you there?
I'm there every day now.
Sure.
The past month.
Just because it's season now, school season.
It's season, but we started in December, I think. We would like to start earlier, but I think as the the plan for the future. Just the thought early so the guys can have a base. Well, some guys doesn't have a base, so they just start training, going into it, speed and everything.
Antonio, in closing, give us 5 tips that you think any young athlete should be doing to change their life and making sport a full-time occupation.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, you need to have that will. You need to be hungry, want to do it. Nobody else can force you to do it. You need to stand up yourself, like go for it. You set goals for yourself and chase the goals till you get it.
And once you get it, what happens then? Do you build and go for the next goal?
Yes, you definitely, once you get the goal, like I set the goal for me, I'm going to break the African record. Mm. So now my aim is I want to go sub 13. But also not just sub 13, I want to start medaling at big competitions.
And how far are you away from that goal?
I'm really not far away. I'm almost there, honestly. Okay. To be honest with you, I'm almost there. The season's still long though, so I can't predict what's going to happen. But I'm hungry. I'm putting in the work. So hopefully it pays off.
Marcel Otto, you've done an amazing job thus far with this young man. And I know there's big things in store. The man wants to medal. The rest on your shoulders and this man's hard work, definitely. Which he's definitely going to do because he's committed to make it happen. Okay. Thank you to your sponsor. Thank you to you for being a role model to our youth. Continue coaching the young athletes as you do and come back with that medal in a couple of months' time and come show us that medal.
Will do. Thank you.
Mr. Alkana, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let's take an ad break and we will come back. We'll chat Q Sports. See you now.